What?
What?
What the hell is this?
Harumph! 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 I didn't get a harumph out of that guy.
Give the governor harumph.
Harumph!
You watch your ass.
I see you shiver with anticipation.
Let the show begin.
Hey, everybody, this is David Heretic coming at you with another edition of Reactions, Reviews, and Rants. And tonight...
Tonight!
All right, we're coming back to Godsmack. Yes, indeed. Godsmack fans, feeling you. Come on now. Here we go. Before we go any further, for those of you who are feeling inclined to doing all of the clicks and the likes and the bibbidi-bobbidi-bob, do me a favor, before you do all that stuff, please watch the whole video first, okay? Give me a chance to actually earn those clicks and likes. Now, after the video's done, if you still feel like doing all those clicks and likes, then by all means, feel free to click away. This comes as a request from AB5, and it was also the winner of the Premier Tier Patreon Request Prioritization Poll, winning with 41% of the vote, moving up from number 716 in the queue straight up to number one. So yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, your voice, your vote does matter. They all want to see me react to this. It is Godsmack with a tune called Saints and Sinners. Now, have I heard this song before? I don't think so. I mean, I've heard a number of Godsmack songs. I own a few albums from Godsmack, but this does not sound familiar. So, as far as I know, I haven't heard the song before. Now, there is a chance that I may have heard the song before, and I just don't realize it. So as always, if I start listening to the song and I suddenly go, wait a minute, hold on, hold the phone, I have heard this before, I'll let you know.
That's the truth.
You know me, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. This was posted by Godsmack, yeah, it's shocking. And the video has 690,000 views. It'll get you there. Other than that, there's really nothing else left to say. Link to the original video will be down below in the video description for your viewing pleasure at your leisure. Let's get started. What do you say? Are you ready? Are you ready? Because here we go. All right, here we go. Saints and Sinners. That's all I got. Got some artwork here. It does say Godsmack, so I hope we're in the right place. Look, this is the link I was given, so if we're not in the right spot, don't blame me, but blame AB5. All right, let's do this.
All right, boy, let's do this.
Simple, easy riff that absolutely just absolutely kicks you right in the chest. I love it. I love everything about it. Hold on. I'm just... Boom. So we are in D. Oh, F sharp. So it's F. Ah, sloppy. Yeah, once you get the riff, it's easy. It's just octaves. You know, you got your 8-1-8-1 to the 10-8-1-8-1-9-8-1-8-1-10-8-1-8-1-9. It's very, very simple. It's not a difficult riff at all. Here's the thing, though, and if you've been following the channel for any amount of time, you probably already know what I'm going to say. It is simple, yes, very simple, but simple can be effective when it's done properly. This is done properly, and I'll tell you what the biggest thing is, the letting the bass take the lead on that riff. It's not guitar. I want you to imagine for a second, listening to the beginning of this song with that bass riff. Now take out the bass and put in guitar instead. It's not going to sound nearly as good. It's going to miss the punch. It's going to miss that bottom end. It's going to miss that nice punchy attack. That's just going to just absolutely light you up right in the chest. And it's really smart the way they did having the bass player take the lead on that line. Very, very smart. I could see this being played live. I could see this absolutely being played live. The bass player comes out front and center of the stage, hits that riff, the crowd loses their mind, and then they go into the song. I could totally see that. It sounds good. It sounds good. Impressive? No, not impressive at all, but it still sounds good. It feels good. And at the end of the day, that's, you know, that's all that really kind of matters. So anyway, let's keep going here. Nobody cares. On the offbeats, okay, instead of the downbeats, offbeats. I like it. I like it. That's nice. Nice ending. Good, solid, definitive ending. I like it. There's 5 seconds left, really? Just cymbal ringing. Yay! Cymbals! Yay! It's good. It's good. I'm not going to sit here and lie to you guys and say I'm amazed or I'm blown away or I think it's great. I'm not going to say that. But it is good. It's definitely good. Now, is it pretty good? Or is it really good? I don't know. Well, guys, we'll have to take a look at everything and figure that part out. Let me get my thoughts together. I'll see you in the review and we'll talk about it. Well, there you go, folks. That was Godsmack with Saints and Sinners. This was a request from AB5, and it was also the winner of the Premier Tier Patreon Request Prioritization Poll, winning it with 41% of the vote, moving it from number 716 in the queue straight up to number one. So yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, your voice, your vote does matter. There's really not a lot to talk about, so this is going to be a short review, I can guarantee it. Let's start with the rating first. Out of a possible 5 stars, I am going to give that 4 stars. Yep, 4 out of 5 stars. I feel good about that score. Let me tell you why.
Why?
Okay, I was kind of on the fence a little bit between 3 stars and 4 stars. And one thing, it really came down to one thing that kind of pushed into the 4-star range for me. So, it's a good song. It is a good song. I'm not gonna say it's a great song. I'm not gonna go that far. But it has a nice groove to it. It has a nice feel to it. The main riff, catchy. It's definitely catchy. The chorus is also catchy. I like the riff in the chorus as well. The progression in the chorus, a little predictable, but not completely. Those flat twos make it a little interesting. If it was just to follow just the Aeolian scale, just, you know, going down from the 6 to the 5 to the 4 to the 3 to the 2, you know, a natural 2, I would be like, that's predictable. I would absolutely call that predictable. But because they were making it the flat 2, it made things interesting. I was like, wait a minute. Hold on now. hold on. That's a little different. I like that. I really like that a lot. Let's see. Vocally, typical Sully vocals. Now, there was that one section, I think it was in the second verse, where he went up a little higher than I normally hear him go. And it sounded good. It didn't sound like he was straining. It sounded like it was supported and it was well delivered. It was projected and it was accurate. So I got no problem with it. A little surprising, you know, but it was good. Guitar playing, thick, crunchy, typical Godsmack sound. Got no problem with that at all. They have a signature sound that they go for, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with it at all. It kind of helps define you as a band. Drumming was absolutely solid. Got no issue with that whatsoever. And like I said, pretty much everything about the song was simple, you know, but like I've always said, simple can be effective when it's done properly. And here's how we ended up at 4 stars. They intelligently, smartly, let the bass take the lead on this song with that riff at the onset and the beginning of the song. I was trying to imagine, what if the guitar, forget the bass, what if the guitar had played that opening riff? You know, the octave to the 3 above, to the octave to the you know, the 2, the flat 2 above. I was thinking to myself, what if it was the guitar doing that? It would have sounded hollow. It would have sounded thin. It would not have sounded nearly as good. They let the bass player take the lead with that nice punch and that nice bottom end rumbling sound. Great way to set the mood and tone for the entire song. I shudder to think what would have happened if they had made it the guitar instead. I don't think it would have been nearly as effective. But because they did let the bass take the lead, they did let the bass take control at the beginning, and to some extent, you heard it also throughout the entire song. Now, granted, the guitar was doubling it to make it sound thick and crunchy, but the bass was still doing the riff, though. It wasn't just hanging out on the root notes. So that was nice. It was nice to see that happen. Honestly, that is the number one reason why we're going with a 4 instead of a 3, is the intelligence to let the bass player take the lead. So the overall, fun song, good listen. Would I listen to it again? Yeah, I would actually. I would absolutely listen to this again. I think I have this album. If I'm not mistaken, that artwork does look familiar. I think I have it. I just haven't listened to it. I have so many albums I have not listened to. You'd be amazed. I have so many freaking albums. I do everything digital. I have an external hard drive of music. It's ridiculous, but it's pretty much full. It's like a 500 gig hard drive, and it's full of music. So yeah, it's one of those albums that I just haven't gotten around to. So I don't know, maybe I should. I don't know if there are any more Godsmack requests in the queue. I'll have to take a look, because I don't want to ruin any potential reactions. So I'll take a look in the queue. If there's no more reactions for Godsmack, then I'm just gonna listen to it. So anyway, 4 stars out of 5. Yeah, man, I feel good with that score. It's a really good song, and I got no problem giving it that 4 out of 5 stars. So 4 out of 5 stars, final score, I have spoken. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of Reactions, Reviews, and Rants. Hope you all enjoyed the show. Hopefully I was able to entertain you. If I was able to put a smile on your face and brighten your day, then I did my job, and I'm so glad I could do it. If you guys feel like joining the fan base, go ahead and click on that button down there. If you guys want to like the video, go ahead and like the video. If you guys want to ring the bell, go ahead and ring the bell. It honestly doesn't make any difference at all to me, but if you guys feel like doing these things, well then, by all means, feel free to do so. Well, that's going to do it for tonight, folks. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, this is David Heretic signing off, reminding you to stay fabulous and support each other. Later. Peace.